Now I'm going to paint my mountains. For the mountain, I have taken black paint, diluted, because we really want a gray color. Basically, what we are creating is a watery gray color. I'm creating a very light shade. See, this is a light gray watery color that I have created out of black. I'll just add a little bit blue. So since these are snow-capped mountains, it has this bluish, grayish look. Assuming that the sun is on the right-hand side and the light is falling on the mountain from the right side of the mountain will be white, whereas the left side over here, we are going to give this gray color, bluish gray watery color. They should be very uneven strokes. So this painting has dried. Now we are going to paint some greenery around this base of the mountain. So here I am taking some green color. What we will do is we will just give some long strokes. Make sure that your base is pretty even, but you can keep giving these strokes. A green color is looking a bit transparent. It is okay. We are going to overlap it with a darker shade. I would request all the students not to copy just the way I'm doing it, but try to experiment with your own thoughts and your own creativity. I'm mixing some dark blue paint, see, very little at the tip of my brush, in this green color. So I got a darker shade. Just check this here. We have this black. We can add this also a little bit. Okay. So here we are now adding it to the base. I'll draw one small house over here with a pencil. It will be very basic. Very basic. I'm going to take some fresh orange color. Taking some yellow ochre color. Giving some grass and a few strokes. little bit outline to the mountain. Again, small dots here and there so that they look like some flower, wild flowers that are growing. You keep it very easy and very simple. Draw a few birds in the sky. Now the birds that we will draw would look like letter M. Landscape scenery is now ready. It's very easy and very simple. I hope you enjoy your painting.